Alexander Gulag with his team of scientists did all kind of documented studies, and from registering energy, he found out when he built the ones in Ukraine and Russia that it, the 44 meter one that he built, in the wintertime when it gets a minus 40 degrees Celsius, water would not freeze inside the pyramid. It was all wood, cladded with fiberglass, and it was 144 feet tall. It did blow down in a terrible storm, and so now he's trying to get funding to do a 100 meter pyramid, which is huge. So there are many, many scientists that are now getting involved in the pyramid idea and getting away from the mystic aspect of it and talking and learning more about the physics of it. And I got fascinated because of what the studies of Gulag, of what he did. So what I've done, this is again based on the Alexander Gulag pi principle, the golden ratio. The angle here is 76 plus degrees, and the base is about 97 inches wide, equal square. I use nylon pins into mortises in order to secure it, keep it in place, and of course nylon won't rust and so forth. And it's also a knockdown, so if I'm ever to move it, I'll have to hire a crew. This wood is Spanish cedar, and it doesn't rot, and I thought that was probably the best way to go. Oak would have been too heavy, though oak will last a long time, but it's impervious to termites and bugs and so forth, so that's why I chose that. And I like the color. There's a little bit of a golden color to it. I could have done a mahogany as well, and it was probably about the same price, but mahogany again is a lot heavier than the Spanish cedar. The finish, I just used a urethane Minwax outdoor Helmsman, and put two coats, and I just wanted to preserve it. And it's been, the one side had been sitting out here for over a month, and water just beads up on it, so I was happy about that. This is a joint here, and it's got dominoes in it for alignment, and this is not 90. Because of the slant and so forth. So you have to calculate that. But once I laid it out in a scale drawing, I knew what my angles were. These are about 17 degrees. And the sides are a little over 205 inches long. And then I have a cap piece that will go on at the very top. So it's gonna be somewhere between 16 and a half to 17 feet tall. It has an 8-foot base. And we're gonna hopefully get it together. What you're gonna have to do is bring your end this way a little bit. Okay, too much, okay. I'm gonna back it up towards you guys. I used two long screws. All right. We need to support that. It didn't go that way.
Can you see how square it is?
Okay. We're not square, but.
Yeah, we should square it up and put a triangle on it with the clamps.
We might have to put it, can we put it underneath that? Okay. And then we'll pivot it up. Let's just see. All right, so what we have to do, everybody on a corner.
Are we rolling it?
No.
No, we're going to lift and just, we'll do it in segments. Lift straight up. Okay, good. Beautiful. Just tell her. All right, we can set it down. We'll do it again. Okay. Ready? Parallel with the rail and the box. Now, okay. All right, now we gotta pivot this one this corner over. It's long enough. I got another rope I can tie to. Ready?
Walk it up. Okay, I'm going around to the other side.
Yep.
Yeah. Just to put that middle.
Randy, just lay in one of those blocks, cushion the blow.
Thank you. That's a good idea. Put my foot right on there. I didn't call it blocks.
I'm so far.
Well, we don't have the weight yet.
Well, I
can come over.
Somebody help Frog over there.
You guys got
to take him all the way.
This is neutral.
I've got it right here.
It is now. It won't be for long.
I got it.
I got tension on the rope.
Coming to the end of your rope.
We're not carrying much of anything here, so.
Yeah. Oh, you're right. That's tall. I got extension ladder. How are you on that stone there?
We've got about an inch and a half.
Okay, that's what we should be. All right, we still got to go this way toward Joel.
This is
got to
go this way.
Yeah, we'll lift it up and then pull that. I just want to get in position.
In the stone here, but not by much.
Okay, we got another couple inches.
All right, let's go a little bit.
Which way are we going?
Towards you.
Yeah,
luckily, I'm not scared of heights. Back in actually 71 or 72, and I built this pyramid and did graphics on it, and it also pierced into a cube. I did a painting of that same thing. This is the actual piercing pyramid into the cube, suspended, and so forth. So these are the varieties. Of course, we have the Giza, we have the Gulad, we have also the Nubian. And Nubian was a city, which is now Sudan in Egypt. And so this has got gold leaf, this is cherry. So I do a variety, and open ones, closed ones, whatever. And whatever material I have, some of them are bird's eye. And New York hasn't really caught on. I've sold about 20 in California, various sizes and shapes. It all depends on the price, how big it is. This has a 12 inch, well, maybe it's a little, maybe 10 and a half inch base. I've done larger ones at 12 inch base. And you can see this is out of tiger maple, mahogany, walnut, cherry. This was the mock-up that I did for this particular pyramid. This is based on the Nubian pyramid. It has an angle of 72 degrees. And I had some leftover Douglas fir. And these are, again, all pinned together. The dowels are what holds the tenon. And then these pins can come out and this can come apart. And as I was talking about earlier, which I knew was going to be a compound, this is a 5-degree angle. So it's actually higher in the inside than it is on the outside because of the angle itself. And I turned this pendulum. It's out of cherry and maple. So I thought it was a nice little element to have a pendulum inside the pyramid and let it free swingly. It's done on a bass guitar string, and so it was fun.